than response. I did that the respondents were not supposed to file a response to your application under section 43.3. That's what I was saying, there was some oversight in requiring for interpreter's hearing for that application. The only way they are supposed to come on board was by challenging. If I had given 30 days, they would have within 15 days filed an application to challenge that period. But when I was giving less than 30 days, I was looking at the event because you are not very sure what's in which account. And I said it might parallel somebody's business. Yeah, was to give a longer period. So I gave a shorter period. But by mistake, we indicated the interparties hearing when actually the service upon the respondents was supposed to trigger an application to be filed challenging the issuance of the expired orders. So I hear the expired orders were not supposed to be replied to. And I think that's why you have not filed any reply.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So we are talking about the preservation or the freezing orders.
Yes, sir.
Isn't that what section 43 says? 345?
That is section 3.
You read the 343.3. What does it tell you? Read it loudly.
Prohibiting that person from transferring, withdrawing, disposing or otherwise dealing with such funds. You know, that is the section or the subsection that now we approach the court and subsection 4 states that the court may issue an order under subsection 3 if the court is satisfied that the conditions specified under subsection 1.
Say, the court?
The court may issue an order under subsection 3 if the court is satisfied that the conditions specified under subsection 1 have been met. And then proceeds to say at 5 that an order made under this section shall be valid for a period of 30 days, but the commissioner may apply to the court for an extension of the period beyond the initial 30 under this section or to the court to discharge or valid the orders.
So that's why they are filed now. They have filed an application to file the orders.
Yes, Your Lordship. Your Lordship, we were served with these applications on the 5th, that is the day before yesterday. Sorry, Your Lordship, on Tuesday, issued. Based on the provisions of that subsection 6, I think that it is for us to then respond to their application.
When were you served?
It was served on the 5th of March 2019.
So what are you asking? What are you?
Yes, Your Lordship, I would require at least 3 days.
The court had directed that that application be served within 3 days. And save for Saturday and Sunday, which was the second and third, the matter was filed within time. The second application, my lord, is the application dated 4th March. Filed by Mr. Humphrey Kariuki seeking joinder into the proceedings. By Humphrey Kariuki on behalf of the proposed third respondent, Humphrey Kariuki filed on 4th of March. In number 10, yes.
So
to be joined in the proceeding, yes, ma'am.
And the other one?
The other one is the application dated 1st of March, filed by Wow Beverages Limited, seeking to set aside the orders.
1st of March?
1st of March. Both raise serious issues. We cannot go into the merits. My lord, my instructions are that Mr. Musyoki would wish to have the application for 4th March for joinder, either agreed by the parties or we can argue the same before we can hear and determine the application dated 1st March. Father, Mr. Musyoki was, if the court is constrained to adjourn the matters, is praying that the matters be heard and determined within the next week, considering that the statutory scheme provides a very limited time period for the court. And if the matters are not heard and determined by next week, then the substratum of the suit and of the application stands to be changed, which is likely to render both applications nugatory of mere academic exercise.
You know,
second of March. If by the 21st of March those orders, that application has not been made, then the matter that will be before the court will not be whether to set aside the court, the orders, but whether to extend the orders.
With regard to the issue of joint relationship, if I may be allowed to just address the court and get the guidance of the court, the purpose of the very specific and limited to the provisions of Section 43 of the Tax Procedures Act, and that is for purposes of preservation of funds. Your Lordship, under these provisions, because Your Lordship, like we indicated, if we file an application, they file an application for discharge, and it's very specific to this section, against a specific party. What I understand them to be saying is that the said Humphrey Kariuki is a director of one of the parties which the orders
were sought against. The respondent issued departure prohibition orders against Mr. Humphrey Kariuki for leaving the country. The reason for issuing of that order was that the first respondent has a huge tax liability. For the for the applicant, they view Humphrey as a taxpayer besides.
Your Lordship, again, I will start guided by the court. But the provisions of subsection 3, section 43, requires the filing of an application. Subsection 6, Your Lordship, then requires filing of, and upon granting of those orders, the statutory period is 30 days, Your Lordship. We are still within the same 30 days, Your Lordship. Subsection 6 then requires the...
they don't have...
yes,
please. They don't have come up at that day.
That is true, Your Lordship.
They will come to share the other system within having insurance.
That is true, Your Lordship. However, my interpretation of that section is that the statutory period run. And if there is an intention to extend, then they would seek to discharge the civil discharge. Now, Your Lordship, just as under section subsection 3, there is no provision under subsection 6 or thereafter for the applicant to then approach the court by way of a response. There is none in the order. However, Your Lordship, for good
when
order.
When they are
having
an application for discharge,
yes, sir.
Would they also come expert?
No, they will not come expert.
So when they are fired, are you supposed to respond?
Yes, Your
Lordship. Defend the expert of us?
Yes, Your Lordship.
Have you filed the response?
To date, we have not.
Why?
Your Lordship, I was seeking instructions for finding the same. And I had actually indicated to my colleague that.
When was up?
It was up on the 5th of March. Your Lordship, that is 3 days ago. I had requested the application to discharge. I would seek the directions of the court to be allowed because by the provisions of subsection 6 is that the applicants, the respondents in which would ordinarily prosecute and show the court the reasons why the orders ought to be discharged.
The original applicant came to court on 22nd February 2019 under section 43, subsection 3, although less than 30 days, and fixed the matter for inter-parties hearing. Since section 43 does not envisage a response to the expiry application, the inter-parties hearing in respect to the application dated 21st February 2019 and filed on 22nd February 2019 is dispensed with. It would not be necessary to hear the inter-parties hearing of your original application. It was supposed to be expired and not supposed to be challenged. However, the respondents have, under Section 436 of the Tax Procedures Act, filed an application dated 1st March 2019, seeking to discharge the expired orders issued on 22nd March 2019. Having filed and served the same on 5th March 2019, the respondent original applicants has not had sufficient time to file a response. I am persuaded to grant 3 days to the respondents in respect to the application dated 1st March 2019 and the 4th March 2019 to file a response. The applicant shall be a third party to file a further affidavit should need arise. However, I have noted that the subject of the suit hearing is purely a tax assessment matter, which squarely falls under the commercial division. According to this file, is referred to the tax division, to the commercial division. To the commercial division presiding judge for further directions, hearing, and termination. Expert interim orders hereby extended. So I'll give you a mention on Monday, on Tuesday, before the commercial division. Right? Tuesday will be when?
12th.
I think Mr. Kiruki.
Yes, sir.
Why did you bring it even to the anti-corruption division? That's assessment.
I think that the UN has given us the proper
commercial division. Number 9, your application is there. There is an application of discharge.
Yes, sir.
So, Mr. Kiruki for the applicant?
Yes, sir. The original applicant.
Yeah, for the.
And Mr. Uma will be appearing for.
Doctor. I appear for Dr. Kiruki.
You are holding brief? Asking for 3 days to which Mr. Omar no objection. What is it? To which you have no objection?
My lord.
Or you had insisted that you serve them, they have not filed?
My lord, in respect to this application, I was ready to proceed. During the application, the instructions to proceed with the application dated 4th March was for all beverages limited. But for the application dated 1st of March, there is no any other pending application. Was filed within the statutory period and served in compliance with the timelines issued by the court. My lord, you will note by the nature of the orders that were granted that they are gravely prejudicial to the respondent. We have only 2 weeks to end determining this application. The respondent is apprehensive that its application will be overtaken by events and that if the application is not added within the timelines, then it will end up being gravely prejudiced and deprived of a statutory right. My lord, in giving your directions, we invite you to be minded that upon filing a response within 3 days, 1 week for the hearing of the petition, of the application, and also for the delivery of the ruling. Without going into the merits, my lord, these accounts have been frozen from 11th February. My lord, there are employees who've not been paid since December last year. The applicants act complained of hearing is likely to cripple this company if this application is not added and determined in the shortest period. My lord, it will be noted that the respondent obtained the orders ex parte on 22nd February 2019. They served them on 27th. February 2019. And by 1st, within 3 days, the respondent had filed this application. My lord, this application is the applicant's application. They are the one enjoying the orders. No cogent reason has been placed before the court why there is no response, considering the the grave injustice being met out on the respondent. His application. And though this has come up in your ruling, my lord, I don't know if I can address it, go to the commercial division. The underlying reasons or grounds for the grant of the orders that were sought was that the respondent was involved in the crimes of tax evasion and tax fraud. That is the underlying ground upon which.
And we kindly urge you to be minded on the grave injustice being visited on the respondent.
The application dated the 1st of March. Sorry, Your Lordships, the application dated the 4th of March. Yeah, the 1st of March. Your Lordship, you realize that application was filed on the 1st of March, but served on the 5th of March. Your Lordship, that is 5 days at least. It is what they took to serve. Your Lordship, we are on the 3rd day from the date of service. Actually, Your Lordship, the 2nd day, if you don't count the 5th. We are on the 2nd day of service. Would amount to an ambush on the applicant. That the orders were taken. Indeed, the Act says that the court can extend the period. Or that period can, on the application of the courts. Yes, Your Lordship. Yes.
Due to my the 2nd of March, the orders would have expired. And therefore, when they are paid, it's certainly not be any consequence because the orders automatically.
They transform the file to the commercial division. I am well guided that there are practice rules that indicated that all tax matters. Dealt with within the commercial and tax division.
To file a response, the matter be mentioned on 12th before the commercial division, who I charge the responsibility of tax assessment and tax related matters. So that they give you directions before the before the presiding judge on 12th March 2019. They'll be able to determine whether they can hear it the following day or after 2 days for the applications. The application dated 1st March. That's I've said the interpreter's hearing in respect to your application dispensed with because it was an oversight. Sasa.
Yeah.
Yeah.